Hi everyone, this is our project on performance analysis of spiral plate heat exchanger using CNT nano plate. Our guide is Dr. S. Mohammed Iqbal, which is in mechanical department, and our team members are these three. And but this is our abstract of our content. What is heat exchanger? Heat exchanger is a device which transfers heat from a fluid at a high temperature to another fluid which is at low temperature. And a spiral plate heat exchangers are known as excellent heat exchanger because of a far compact and high heat transfer efficiency. It is a compact in size, which means it is for other type of heat exchanger, it is in a small size. And a new arrangement for the flow of hot and cold fluid is implied for design. And hot fluid and cold fluid in this flow in a spiral path. And in this design, two steel sheet bell roll together around a central coil. As a result, two separate channel bell made because of less falling. In this, falling is less and easier cleaning. More heat transfer coefficient. A spiral heat exchanger is a good alternative to the other type of heat exchanger, especially when it is going to handle high viscous fluid. In this methodology, here we are taking water and CNT nano fluid as hot fluid and cold fluid. We are going to vary mass flow rate, and to determine the type of flow, we need to find the Reynolds number for the flow passage. It depends on the equivalent diameter and the hydraulic diameter of the heat exchanger. Then by taking various outlet parameter reading, heat transfer will be calculated by using the relation Q equal to UA into LMTD. This is our design. In this, it is cold fluid inlet and hot fluid outlet, and this is a hot fluid outlet, and this is cold fluid outlet, and this is a hot fluid inlet. Here you can see this is only one surface in contact between hot and cold fluid, so that here heat transfer is a little bit less, but here you can see both here hot fluid, cold fluid, and hot fluid. These are two surfaces in contact, and so here heat transfer will take more. So this is the benefit of this type of heat exchanger. Here two surfaces cut, so heat transfer, more heat transfer will take place. So this is basically benefit of using this spiral plate heat exchanger. And this is our working model. Here is a hot fluid inlet. This is our rotometer. From this we here it is a rotometer. From this we get what is the flow rate of hot water, and here is another rotometer for finding the flow rate of cold water. This is inlet of hot water, this is outlet of hot water, and this is the inlet of cold water, and this is the outlet of cold water. From the here we put one heater, and heat the water, and we maintain it at 50, 60, and 70, and we take the reading by using this one temperature indicator, and we find what is the inlet temperature of hot water, what is the outlet temperature of hot water, and what is the inlet temperature of cold water, and what is the outlet temperature of cold water. And from this we find heat transfer by cold water and the hot water and the Reynolds number by using flow rate and all these parameters. And material method and material. Hot water is filled in a container, and as I have told you, these are the material. Cold fluid tank, hot fluid tank, pump for cold fluid, pump for hot fluid, and a valve cup for cold fluid. And these are all the material we are using. This is the formula used. H is the height, And S is the space between the channel, and nu is kinematic viscosity, which for water we are taking 8.9 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. M is a mass flux, which is calculated by mass flow rate, which we are taking, and H into S. And this is Nusselt number. This is the formula for Nusselt number, and this is equivalent diameter formula, the Nusselt number formula, and heat transfer equal to Q to empty. This is heat transfer by hot fluid, this is the heat transfer by cold fluid, and delta T1 TH inlet minus TC outlet, delta T2 TH outlet minus TC inlet. This is the mean radius, and this is hydraulic diameter, 2 into BS upon B plus S. And in this way, for equivalent heat transfer, we are taking by using this formula QS plus QC by 2. And for calculating the for calculation for of area of a spiral plate, we are using L1 equal to these are the channel length. By using this formula, we calculate the channel length. And for area of a spiral plate, we calculate by using formula L1 plus L2 into H. From this, we find the area equal to 1.8 meter square. This is the LMTT formula, as you all know, equal to delta T1 minus delta T2 upon LN T1 upon T2. And for calculation of using nano plate, same as where we only vary new kinematic viscosity, we are taking 7.42 into 10 to the power minus 4 and a front end number. We are using same formula for calculating the Nusselt number, Nusselt number, and all the QH and QC. Only difference in new and front end number. This is our tabulated reading for water. We are, as I told you, we maintain hot water then 60, 70 and 50. From this way, we calculate QH, QC and U, overall transfer efficiency, Reynolds number and Nusselt number. And this is this is for we maintain here we maintain the cold fluid at 1000 rph, and here we maintain hot fluid at 1000 rph, and we vary the flow rate for cold fluid, and here we vary the flow rate of hot fluid, and same we calculate QHQC and U efficiency, Nusselt number and Reynolds number. From this we plot the graph between the Reynolds number and Nusselt number for both the three temperatures 50, 60 and 70. We find the graph like this, and for Reynolds number versus efficiency we find the graph like this for same 60, 50 and 70 temperature. And this is the tabulated reading for CNT nano fluid. Here we fixed hot fluid at 1000 rph, and we vary the CNT nano fluid flow rate, and we maintain the temperature at 50, 60 and 70. Here you can see MC, and here one MC, which is at 50 degrees centigrade, and same as for maintaining the temperature of hot CNT nano fluid at 1000 rph, and we vary the flow rate of cold water, and we find all the QH, QC and the Reynolds number, Nusselt number, and we plot the graph between the Reynolds number versus Nusselt number like this at 1000 hot foot nano fluid fixed at 1000 rph. And this is the efficiency versus Reynolds number versus efficiency. From this we concluded that for when we are using CNT nano fluid, the efficiency will be more. Here you can see the conclusion. First we have done validation with water. After performing the experiment, we have noticed that heat transfer rate has increased, and also the higher value of efficiency as we got compared to the conventional heat transfer. So here the conclusion is that when we are using the CNT nano fluid, we are getting more effectiveness with compared to the water when we take water. So you can say that when the viscosity will be more, the effectiveness will be more for any fluid. And this is we gained a lot of practical knowledge regarding planning, processing and assembling the experiment. And these are the cores of material. We have expended almost 25,000 for doing this project. This is the objective. Main objective is to maximize the heat transfer rate so as to reduce the mechanical damage of the moving machinery part, to enhance the life of a moving machinery part and to reduce the falling effect. These are the literature service. Here the various persons are involved in developing this spiral plate sensor, and they are actually more on the various parameter, and they are developed various parts of the spiral plate sensor. Here is the thermal performance, and these are the thermal performance, and here is the designing of a spiral plate, and designing of these are the professor and scientist which are involved in developing this project. And problem definition is that the major problem is in a heat exchanger is a falling, which leads to decrease the heat transfer. If a falling will be there, then automatically the heat transfer will reduce, causing a decrease in thermal efficiency. And the conventional heat exchanger occupy a large surface area, which causes a hindrance of heat transfer. So this in a spiral heat exchanger, the conventional area will be less. So these are the benefit, and this is the reduce the problem. Expected outcome is that the spiral heat exchanger uses a self-cleaning mechanism where the fault surface causes a localized increase, and this is the expected outcome. The spiral heat exchanger is rolled together, making it compact in size and easy to transport. And these are the application. It is used in the refinery and protochemicals, biogas, waste parts of power treatment, paper and pulp industry, and the many industry which are in thermal. So these are our conclude of our project, and thank you.